Dear follower of Geometric Designs, the topic of today's tutorial is AKICAD Automatic Roof Settings Mathematical Formulas. AKICAD Automatic Roof Settings Mathematical Formula. In AKICAD, automatic roof setting is used when designing a simple roof that has all the roof levels on the same level. In such design, there is absence of stepped up or down level. None of the roof level is higher than other. All roof levels are at the same level. Let's go to our AKICAD drawing board. Let me show you something. Let's go to our 3D. Now we have this roof done. Our 3D, you can see. Watch the parapet. You will observe that all the roof level are at the same level. There is no roof level that is higher than others. All of them are at the same level. In this kind of design, what we use is automatic roof settings. Automatic roof settings. That is what you use to design a simple roof that has all the roof level at the same level. None is higher than others and none is lower than others. Beautiful. Let's go to section 3. Let me show you something. Now, to design automatic roof, there are things that one should know. Let's highlight this roof. Now, in this roof, you can see the thickness of the roof known as T. We just assigned a term T to it. That's the thickness of the roof. You can see it. This thickness. That is called the thickness of roof. If you don't call it the thickness of the roof, you call it the perpendicular thickness of the roof. Then we also have this V. You see this V? This V is the thickness of the edge of the roof. The thickness of the edge of the roof. The thickness of the edge of the roof. Take a look. From this spot to this spot is the thickness of the roof at the edge. That's the thickness at the edge. That is V. Now, this V is also by trigonometrical designs. We have this vertical distance here as also the same as V. You can also call it V. So V is the vertical height of the roof edge. The vertical height of the roof edge. If you don't call it the vertical height of the roof edge, you call it the vertical thickness of the roof edge. The vertical thickness of the roof edge. This is perpendicular thickness of the roof edge. This is vertical thickness of the roof edge. That is V. These terms are very important, we know about them. So we know it as the vertical thickness of the roof edge. Then another term we need to look at is roof pitch. Roof pitch or roof angle. Roof angle is the angle the slope of the roof makes with the horizontal. Take a look, this is horizontal, the horizontal level, and this is the slope of the roof. The angle this slope makes with this horizontal, this angle here, which we call theta, that is your roof slope. Another term we look at is the roof edge angle. Roof edge angle. Roof edge angle is the angle the edge of the roof makes with the slopey side, the slope plane of the roof. For instance, let me deselect. If you observe here, you have this red line. You see this red line? That shows us the slope, the roof of the roof. Then we also have this red line here, which defines the edge of the roof. Now, the angle between these two red lines is what we call the edge angle of the roof. Now, you might ask, why is it that the edge angle which we assign alpha is the same as theta? Yes, in our settings, in every AKICAD roof setting where you want the edge of the roof to sleep, lie down flat on top of the parapet, in any situation, in a case where you want the roof edge to lie flat on top of the parapet, the edge angle and the slope of the roof must be the same. Let's check our roof settings here. In our roof settings here, you can see this angle here. This angle is called your roof pitch. That is your roof pitch. Now, this angle here is the edge angle. This edge angle must be the same with the slope. Once you have 45 degrees here, you must have 45 degrees. In this case, whenever you have these same figures, it means that the roof edge is going to slip, lie flat on top of your parapet. Take note of that. It's not only 45 degrees that we use in this case. You can use 30 degrees. You can use any angle of your choice. But the bottom line, one thing you must ensure is that the angle of the slope and also the edge angle are the same. Whatever value assigned to the slope, assign the same value to the edge. Noted. Now, let's go back. Let's go back to our section. Now, we have this T as the distance from this part to this part is the same thing as from here to here, which means this thickness we have here is also the thickness we have here. That is why we have T here and we have T here. What are we trying to do? We are trying to use simple trigonometry to derive relation between V, T, Y, and theta. that noted. Then another thing we look at is if overhang. Let's go to our roof setting. Let me show you. Can you see it here? If overhang. Okay, look at it here. The if overhang is the projection of the roof edge from the wall. The projection of the roof edge beyond the wall or the parapet edge. This is our parapet edge. Can you see it? Now, this projection from this spot to this spot is what we call the roof if overhang. We assigned a value of y to it. That is a term. We assigned y to it. Then, another thing we look at is the vertical height of the roof edge. I have explained that. That is this edge of the roof. This edge of the roof. That is the same thing as this V. Remember, from this spot to this spot is the same thing as from here to here. By measurement, let's try it by measurement. If we pin at this spot and measure towards here, what you have is 353.6. If you turn it towards this way, you have 353.6. See, if we move inside, let's start from this parapet edge. From this spot to this spot will give you 303.6. If you bring it down at this level, you also have 303.6. Take note of that. Take note of that. That is your V. The value from here to here is the same as from here to here. Now, we'll be looking for a formula that will connect this height and this thickness with this Y as well. We'll find a formula for it. Now, let's look at another thing. Base offset to home story. Base offset to home story. Base offset. Now, base offset to home story is the height difference between the base of the roof and the story level where the roof is drawn. Now, this is our story level. Can you see? We label the story stroke reference level. That is this line here. Okay? You can see it is story 2, which is at plus 600 level. Now, the difference in height between this level and this level, this base, take note, this is the base of your roof. It is called base offset. If you check in our roof settings, look at it here. Can you see? Base offset. This is one challenge every archi student or architect have. Determining this value have always been a problem. Now, in this tutorial, we are going to show you a mathematical relation that will solve that problem once and for all. A permanent mathematical formula that solves that problem so that you can determine your base offset by calculation. Now, that noted, we assign the value data. If you are conversant with your calculus, if you did your calculus very well, you will know that this sign represents data. Data in mathematics, it means height difference, it means difference. So that's the gap, the difference between this base and this story level. That's your data. We call it what? Base offset. Another one is roof base. Roof base is this line here. This is where your roof has its base. Don't mistake this level as your roof base. That is not your roof base. That is your edge base. This is edge base. This is roof base. Edge base, roof base. Your edge is sitting on top of the parapet, whereas your base is projecting below the parapet. Can you see that? That's your roof base. Take note of that. Another thing we shall be looking at is our roof level. Beautiful. That is this dotted line. This dotted line is our roof level. Now, your roof level is the level the edge of the base, the base edge of the roof sits on. That is the level you want the base of the edge of your roof to sit on. That is your roof base. Take note of that. Then, there is also a height difference between the roof level and the story level. Height difference between roof level and story level. You can see the gap, this space gap. We assign the term D to E. Let's go. Let's continue. Now, let's look at the formula of ArchiCAD automatic roof settings. I have taken time to do my research and come up with a formula that solves the problem once and for all. And this formula that helps us to find the base offset of a roof and the vertical height of the edge. This is the two formulas. First is V equals to T over cos theta minus Y tan theta. Let's explain this formula so that you understand it. Where V is vertical thickness of roof edge. Let me show you. Look at that V we are talking about here. The vertical thickness of the roof edge. Can you see this V? From this spot to this spot is your V. Or from this spot to this spot. Let me use line. From this spot to this spot is V. That is the vertical height of your roof edge or vertical thickness of your roof edge. If you don't call it vertical height of roof edge, you call it vertical thickness of roof edge. Then from this spot to this spot is your V. Also from here to this spot is your V. If you don't take off from here and you take from this spot to this spot is your V. Or from this spot to this spot is your V. But to avoid mistake, to avoid error, always concentrate on this spot, from this spot to this spot, this height. Let's use this. Let's use this vertical offset. Now, from your edge offset, from the edge of your roof to the base of your roof is what we call the vertical height of the roof edge. From the base of the edge, this is the base of the edge, this is your edge, and this is the base of it. The distance from here, from this spot, to the base of this your roof, is what we call the vertical height of the roof edge. And we assigned a value V to it. Take note. From this spot to this spot, that is what is important, V. Let's go back. Then we say T is perpendicular thickness of roof. T is perpendicular thickness of roof. Let's go to our roof. Let me show you what T is. Can you see T? Look at it here. This thickness, that is the perpendicular thickness of your roof. Let's go back. Then Y is if overhang or offset. Y is if overhang. Let's go to our roof. Let me show you. The space from this spot to this spot, this projection beyond this parapet, this projection here, is what we call the if overhang. If you go to your roof setting here, look at it here. That's your if overhang. So what I am trying to do is to create a mathematical relation that connect this angle, this thickness, this overhang, in order to help us get this base offset. That's what we are moving to. A mathematical relation that connects the roof thickness, the roof slope angle, the roof if overhang to get this base offset. That is the mathematical relation we are working on. So that is what we are moving to. Let's go back to our equation. So then theta is roof pitch or roof angle. Roof pitch or roof angle. Look at it here. The slope of the roof. If you go to your roof setting, this is your theta. This is your T thickness. This is your theta. This is your Y roof overhang. And this is your delta base offset of the roof. Beautiful. Now, let us proceed. Let's proceed. Now we have equation number two. Equation number two is delta equals to plus or minus D minus V. Where delta is roof base offset. Let's go to our roof. Let me show you what delta is. Can you see? Delta. Roof base offset. The height difference between story level and the base of the roof. We are not talking about this base. The height difference between story level and the base of the roof. That is your delta. That is your delta. We have a mathematical relation that helps us to get that. Now, we call it delta. Then we have D. We have D, height difference between roof level and story level. Let me show you that. Height difference between roof level. Can you see your roof level? This is your roof level. Roof level is the level where your roof sits on. Flat. Where your roof sits flat on. That is your roof level. It can be the parapet top. So you can see the height difference between this roof level and this story level. We assign D to E. That is your D. So let's go back. And then we have V. We already know V here. V is the vertical height of the roof edge. We already have it in equation 1. Now, the essence of using equation 1 and 2 is, with equation 1, you get the value of V. Then substitute it in this equation 2 and get the value of your base offset. Now, let us conduct a simple roof design. Example 1. Let us design a roof. Given that the thickness of the roof is 500, roof angle, that is theta, equals to 40 degrees, and if overhang Y equals to 100 mm. Let's go to our roof setting. We shall not be using this roof. Let's go to our 3D. We have already done this. We have already done the design of this roof. Now we want to design the roof that we just mentioned now. The example one that we just get now, we want to design that roof on this parapet. So we shall be considering this building this time around. Let's go to our plan. In our plan, we have this second building which we want to install the roof on. And mind you, we have to choose a story level 1 where we want to install the roof. I am choosing story level 2. Story level 2. That is where I want to do the design. Now, let's click on our roof. Using the example that has been given us. Remember, in the example here, we say the thickness of the roof Let us design a roof given that the thickness of the roof T is 300. Roof angle theta is 40 degree. And the overhang Y 100. Let's go to our roof setting and change this to 300, as we said, 300. Then theta angle is 40 degree, as we have. Remember, I told you previously, the roof slope and the edge slope must always be the same figure if you want it to sit flat on the parapet. If you want the roof to sit flat on the parapet. So let's change this to 40 as well. Beautiful. Let's change this overhang to 100, as we just gave now. Let's complete it. 100. Beautiful. Now, we have a challenge here. That is this base offset. We can't get this base offset. We can't figure it out. There is no way you can figure it out. You can't assign any value to it. First of all, click OK. Don't install the roof. Go to your calculation board. Go to your calculation board and do your calculation. Now that we have T to be 300, roof angle 40 degree, if overhang Y 100 mm, let us substitute it in equation 1, which is V equals to T cos T over cos theta minus Y tan theta. Let us substitute. T is 300, we have it here. Can I say 300? Theta is 40 degree, we have cos theta, minus Y is 100. You can see it here. And the theta, which is 40, we have tan 40. Now let's proceed. Now, 300 cos 40 degree by calculation. If you punch in your calculation, let us check it. 40 cos. You see what you have there? 0.7660 approximately. Look at it. 0.7660 approximately. Now let us take our tan 40 as well. 40 tan. Do you see what you have there? 0.8390. Because this last figure is 0 and the figure next to it is above 5, which is 9. We change it to value of 1 and add it to this 0 so that we have 8391. So we have it as 0.8391. Now, breaking down this calculation further, you have 391.6 minus 83.9. Finally, by calculation, you have V to be 307 by 3.307.7. That is the value of your V. Noted. Let us proceed. Now that we have the value of V, all we need to do is to substitute it in the second equation. Using this second equation, delta equals to plus or minus D minus V. This is the formula that now gives us the base offset of the roof. Remember, delta is the base offset of the roof, as I said earlier. Now, what we need to find out is the value of our D. Let's go to our roof. In this roof that we want to install, open, click on section 01. Click on it. Open section 01. Now, can you see section 01? Take a look. Take a closer look at it. Do you see the roof level? This is the roof level of section 01. This is the story level where we are doing the drawing. Now, what we need to find is the height difference between this roof level and this story level. By calculation, the height difference is 500. Is that noted? 500. Beautiful. Let's go back here. So, our D is 500. Since the roof level is above story or reference level, D will be positive. Let's go back to our drawing board. Can you see? This roof level is above story level. Take note. When we have in this formula, delta equals to plus or minus D minus V. This plus or minus defines the position of the roof level. If the roof level is above this reference level, for instance here, this roof level is above this story level, then D will have a positive value. But if this reference level is above this roof level, for instance, let me show you something. Story level 2. Let's move this story level. Watch what I'm doing. Do you see where we have the story level now? This story level is now above this roof level. In this case, the value of D will be negative. You'll be assigning negative value to D. Let's cancel. Here, our story level is below roof level. In this case, D will have a positive value. Take note of that. Let's go back to our calculation board. It is our calculation board. Now that we know that D is 500, and we already know the value of V, which is 307.7, let us do a simple calculation there. We just have 500, that is the substitute for D. You have 500, substitute for V, you have 307.7. Now 500 minus 307.7, you have 192.3. That is your base offset. 192.3. Now copy this value back to your roof setting. Go back to your drawing board. Go back to your floor plan. Now, go back to roof setting. Now, in this roof setting, we know what we can now type in here. 192.3. So, you just simply go here and type 192.3. you have completely set your roof. The moment you draw this roof, make sure that your model is set on. You click all these things on. You on all of them. Then click OK. And start drawing your roof on this paper. After drawing it, watch out and see how beautiful this will look like. You don't need to do any adjustment. You see that? Now, let's take it in our 3D. Beautiful. This is lovely. This is... Now, we are done with this roof design. But look at what we are going to do. We are going to delete this roof. Let's delete it and install a fresh roof. Delete. Let's go to our section 01. Now, previously, we installed roof on this parapet using only 3 stories. That is your ground floor, first story, second story. This time around, I want to introduce another story level above this level. By this introduction, this roof level will be below that story level. Let's go to our floor plan and go to our story settings. Let's click insert above. We're going to insert above this story level 2. Insert above. That becomes story level 3. And let's click OK. Beautiful. You want story level 3. In this your story level 3, the parapet did not appear. Now what do? Move down to story level 2. Just use pulley line and trace out the roof, the parapet layout. Let's press it out. Now, having gotten it like this, just right click and copy it. Just copy it and paste in story 3. Beautiful. Click on your story 3 and paste it there. Beautiful. You now have the parapet layout of it. Now, we are going to install this roof on this story 3. Let's go back to our F01, section 01. Let's open it. Let me show you something there. Can you see the third story? This story level 3 is above this roof level. In other words, the roof level is below this story 3. Now, remember what I told you earlier? When the roof level is below the story level of the design, D will assume a negative value. When the roof level is below the story level of the design, D assumes a negative value. By measurement, let us measure the distance. The distance between the story, the roof level and the story 3 level. Let's use our measurement material from this spot to this spot. We have 2600. Write it down. 2600. That noted. Now, let's go to our calculation board. We already know the value of data. No, we don't know the value of data. That is the base offset of the roof is what we want to get this time around. Now, we know the value of V. V is already known, which is 3.07.7. That is, we are using the previous setting of the roof. Let's go to our roof setting. Let me show you something there. Let's go to our roof setting. Remember, this is our roof setting. 300 as thickness, 40 degree as roof slope, 40 degree as edge angle, and 100 mm as the overhang. We are maintaining this figure, but what is going to change this time around is the base offset. Why? Because we are designing the roof on a new level. We are using a new story level, which is story level 3. Now, this story level 3 is above the roof level. So, the base offset of the roof is going to change. It must change. Why I have to do the designs in two ways? First design we did is the base, the roof level was above the reference level. We used story 2. We used story 2 in that design. In that story 2, story 2 is below the roof level. But in this second design now, story 3 is above the roof level. So the roof base offset is going to alter. Take note of that. We are going to perform our simple calculation. We've already done our calculation. Our V is, the value of our vertical edge is constant. So let's go back to our calculation board. In this calculation board, all we need to do is data. All we need to do is find data. Find data. We find our data. Find data using the relation. Using the relation data. that I was to plus or minus D. Plus or minus D minus V. That's the relation we are going to use. But in this case, D is negative. Why? Because the roof level is below the reference level. Let's go to our section 01. Check your section 01 and see. You see, the roof level is below this story level. We are doing this roof design on this story 3. And this story 3 is above the roof level. In other words, the roof level is below it. Because the roof level is below it, the value of D will be negative. Remember, we have done our measurement to obtain the value as 2600. Take it once again, 2600. That note, let's go to our calculation board. Now, by substitution, beta is equivalent to, beta is equal to 2 minus 2600 minus 307.7. Is that noted? This is your V. That is 307.7. So remember, I introduced negative sign here. Why? Because the roof level is below the reference level of the design. That will give us equals to, by calculation, let's do it here and see what we'll have. 2600 by if we add them together, because this negative will give us a negative formation. If you are conversant with your negative calculation, plus 307.7. So what you are having is 2907.7. So your answer will be minus 2907.7. Minus 2907.7 mm. Take note. So this will be our new base offset of the roof. Let's go back to our roof. Make sure you write this figure down. 2907.7 negative. Let's go back to our roof design. Go to your floor plan. The floor plan we are using is the floor level 3. That is where I want to install this roof on. So let's go and alter the roof and change this figure to minus 2907.7. That is our new base offset of the roof. The roof base offset is the new figure. So let's click OK. And let's draw our roof. And see if we are going to achieve the same result of having the roof sitting flat on the parapet. Let's check our 3D and see. Beautiful. This is wonderful. You see, at any story level you choose, all you need to do is to perform your simple calculation and get your base offset. Once you have that base offset and install it, draw your roof. The roof will sit properly on top of the parapet level. Remember, the previous design we did was using roof level that is above reference level. In this second design, we use roof level that is below reference level, and we achieve the same result. That is to show you that the formula that I have given you is a permanent solution to this challenge. I hope you enjoy this tutorial. Thank you for watching.